Arts for the Community at Thomas University presents Sundays at 4. As a partner grant recipient, this program is supported in part by Georgia Council for the Arts through the appropriations of the Georgia General Assembly. Georgia Council for the Arts also receives support from its partner agency, the National Endowment for the Arts. This project is supported in part by an award from the National Endowment for the Arts, on the web at arts.gov. Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the kickoff of our regular Act 2 season. We're starting this year off with a Sunday at 4. Happy birthday, Sondheim. Stephen Sondheim was one of the most important figures in 20th century American musical theater. He is said to have reinvented the American musical with music and lyrics of unprecedented complexity and sophistication. Many of his songs are challenging both musically and intellectually. During the pandemic, we've been impacted very clearly, as everyone has. We would normally be, for this program, at the Music and Drama Troupe building, but this year we were unable to bring everybody together because we want to remain safe. So we are bringing you people today from their locations, and you know, we can't control everything. It's a struggle, but we are still at it, and we are still doing what we can to bring you entertainment and a little bit of relief from the pandemic that seems to go on and on. I'm also partnering this year with a couple of other groups and starting a couple new initiatives, so we will be seeing some of that in addition to our regular season. We were very fortunate this year to get a grant from the Georgia Council for the Arts, funded through the National Endowment for the Arts. Very excited about that, but we still need you. Part of the grant is that the requirement is we need to match those funds, and the way that we match those funds is you. We need your donations. We need you to be a partner in the arts with us. It's very simple. If you see the address right here, it's a simple way for you to join us and support the arts right here in Thomasville. This is making an economic impact for the people and the musicians who are going to be visiting us as guests, virtually and in person. We're going to be doing as much as we can to bring audiences wherever they happen to be. And we're going to be staying at our regular locations. We're going to be at the public library this fall. We're going to be at the First United Methodist Church. We're starting a partnership for some concerts in October with First Presbyterian Church. So we are reaching out every way that we can to bring a little bit of happiness and music your way. There is some likelihood that we're going to be moving away from Facebook because they've just changed the terms of service to include some issues that they do not want the platform to be a musical listening experience. So we will be looking at other ways, and we'll let you know about that. So the program will continue with essentially what was pre-recorded, but just as Nicole said to me, she would rather do 6 weeks of rehearsals than the craziness that we have been through just leading into this weekend. Really, the challenges of the pandemic and the discovery of new skills and learning of new skills and talents that we had no idea that we had are all part of this process. So we're there with you, and we're doing everything we can to bring you the kind of music and entertainment that you want. So sit back, relax, and enjoy our program. Happy birthday, Sondheim. Gypsy, a Musical Fable, is a 1959 musical with music by Jules Stein and lyrics by Stephen Sondheim. Gypsy is loosely based on the 1957 memoirs of striptease artist Gypsy Rose Lee, and focuses on her mother, Rose, who is the ultimate show business mother. It follows the dreams and efforts of Rose to raise two daughters to perform on stage and casts an affectionate eye of the hardships of show business life.
Some people can get a thrill knitting sweaters and sitting still. That's okay for some people who don't know they're alive. Some people can thrive and bloom living life in the living room. That's perfect for some people of 105. But I at least gotta try. When I think of all the sights that I gotta see and all the places I gotta play, all the things that I gotta be at, come on, Papa, what do you say? Some people can be content playing bingo and paying rent. That's peachy for some people, for some humdrum people to be. But some people ain't me. I had a dream, a wonderful dream, Papa. All about June in the Orpheum circuit. Give me a chance and I know I can work it. I had a dream, just as real as can be, Papa. There I was in Mr. Orpheum's office, and he was saying to me, Rose, get yourself some new orchestrations, new routines, and red velvet curtains. Get a feathered hat for the baby, photographs in front of the theater. Get an agent, and in jig time, you'll be being booked in the big time. What a dream, a wonderful dream, Papa. And all that I need is 88 bucks, Papa. That's what he said, Papa. Only 88 bucks. I'm not getting 88 cents from you. Well, I'll get it someplace else. Goodbye. Socials I had to go to, all the lodges I had to play, all the Shriners I said hello to. Hey LA, I'm coming your way. Some people sit on their butts, got the dream, yeah, but not the guts. That's living for some people, for some humdrum people, I suppose. Well, they can stay and rock.
A Funny Thing Happened on the Way to the Forum is a 1962 musical with music and lyrics by Stephen Sondheim. Inspired by the farces of the ancient Roman playwright Plautus, the musical tells the bawdy story of a slave named Pseudolus and his attempts to win his freedom by helping his young master woo the girl next door. The plot displays many classic elements of farce, including puns, the slamming of doors, cases of mistaken identity, and satirical comments on social class. The musical's original 1962 Broadway run won several Tony Awards, including Best Musical and Best Author.
Once upon a time it happened, there lived a boy who loved a girl. Your eyes are blue, and every single night he'd see her across the way. I'd want to say, he'd want to say, your eyes are blue, and I love you, but never had he spoken, never had he dared. Beautiful as she was, I was, he was scared. Then suddenly one day he met her and he could see her eyes were blue as they could be. What did he do? Well,
Hotspot is a 1963 musical with music by Mary Rogers, lyrics by Martin Charmnin, and additional lyrics and music by Stephen Sondheim. It had a brief run on Broadway in 1963. It is a political satire about a Peace Corps volunteer in newly independent Nigeria who caused a furor because she had written a postcard describing the primitive living conditions there. Nigerians were indignant, and some accused the volunteers of being American spies. This led to a public relations crisis for the fledgling Peace Corps, and definitely a shorter run for the musical.
Show me a glass of water, and I'll show you a socky dress. Show me a tube of toothpaste, and I'll show you a mess. Show me a fresh laid sidewalk, and guess where my footprints are. Show me a fire hydrant, I'll show you my car. Show me the latest dance step, and I'll show you latest fall. Show me the train to Boston, I'll show you St. Paul. Show me 100 lighters, and I'll show you the one that won't. Show me a priceless vase. No, don't. Maybe it's my name. Maybe it's my face. Maybe it's my both. All I know is show me a cancel party, and I'll show you the only guest. Show me an open manhole, and I'll show you the rest. Show me a broken window, and I'll show you my bat and ball. Show me the train to Europe, and I'll show you St. Paul. Maybe it's my name. Maybe it's my face.
Anyone Can Whistle, a 1964 musical that tells the story of an economically depressed town whose corrupt mayoress, in an attempt to draw tourists, decides to create a fake miracle, which draws the attention of Faye Apple, an emotionally inhibited nurse, a crowd of inmates from a local asylum called the Cookie Jar, and a doctor with secrets of his own, described by theater historian Ken Mandelbaum as a satire on conformity and the insanity of the so-called sane.
Everybody says don't, everybody says don't, everybody says don't, it isn't right, don't, it isn't nice. Everybody says don't, everybody says don't, everybody places to walk on the grass. Don't disturb the peace. Don't skate on the ice. How I say do. I say walk on the grass. It was meant to fail. I say sail. Tilt in the windmill. And if you fail, you fail. Everybody says don't. Everybody says don't. Everybody says don't get out of line. When they say that, then that's a sign. 9 times out of 10, you're doing just fine. Make just a ripple. Come on, be brave. First time a ripple. Next time a wave. Sometimes you have to start small. Climb up the tiniest wall. Maybe you're going to fall, but it's better than not starting at all. Everybody says don't, everybody says stop. Everybody says mustn't rock the boat. Mustn't touch a thing. Everybody says stop, everybody says wait. Everybody says can't fight City Hall. Don't upset the court. Can't laugh at the king. Well, I say try. I say laugh at the king or he'll make you cry. Lose your poise. Fall if you have to, but maybe make some noise. Everybody says don't, everybody says can't. Everybody says wait around for miracles. That's the way the world was made. I insist on miracles. If you do them, miracles, nothing to them. I say don't. Don't be afraid.
Company is a 1970 musical comedy with music and lyrics by Stephen Sondheim. Originally titled Threes, its story revolves around Robert, the five married couples who are his best friends, and his three girlfriends. Unlike most book musicals, which follow a clearly delineated plot, Company is a concept musical composed of short vignettes, presented in no particular chronological order, linked by a celebration for Robert's 35th birthday. Company was among the first musicals to deal with adult themes and relationships, and Sondheim wrote, "Broadway theater has been for many years supported by upper-middle-class people with upper-middle-class problems. These people really want to escape that world when they go to the theater, and then here we are with Company talking about how we're going to bring it right back in their faces."
I'd like to propose a toast. Here's to the ladies who lunch. Everybody laugh. Lounging in their caftans and planning a brunch on their own behalf. Off to the gym, then to a fitting, claiming they're fat. And looking grim, 'cause they've been sitting, choosing a hat. Does anybody even still wear a hat? I'll drink to that. And here's to the girls who stay smart. Aren't they a guess? Rushing to their classes in optical art, wishing it would pass. Another long, exhausting day. Another $1,000. A matinee, a pinter play. Piece of mothers. I'll drink to that. Oh, and one for Mahler. And here's to the girls who play wife. Aren't they too much? Keeping house for clutching a copy of life just to keep in touch. The ones who follow the rules and meet themselves at the schools, too busy to know that they're fools. Aren't they a gem? I'll drink to them. Let's all drink to them. And here's to the girls who just watch. Aren't they the best? When they get depressed, it's a bottle of scotch plus a little jest. Another chance to disapprove. Another brilliant zinger. Another reason not to move. Another vodka stinger. Here's to the girls on the go. Everybody tries. Look into their eyes and you'll see what they know. Everybody dies. A toast to that invincible bunch. The dinosaur surviving the crunch. Let's hear it for the ladies who lunch. Everybody rise.
Someone to hold you too close. Someone to hurt you too deep. Someone to sit in your chair and ruin your sleep and make you aware of being alive. Being alive. Someone to need you too much. Someone to know you too well. Someone to pull you up short and put you through hell and give you support is being alive. Being alive. Being alive. Someone you have to let in. Someone whose feelings you spare. Someone who, like it or not, will want you to share a little, a lot is being alive. Being alive. Someone to crowd you with love. Someone to force you to care. Someone to make you come through, who'll always be there, as frightened as you, to help us survive. Being alive. Being alive. Being alive. Someone to know you too well. Someone to pull you up short and put you through hell and give you support for being alive. Being alive. Somebody hold me too close. Somebody hurt me too deep. Somebody sit in my chair and ruin my sleep and make me aware of being alive. Make me alive. Make me alive. Make me confused. Crowd me with love. Somebody force me to care. Somebody make me come through. I'll always be there, as frightened as you, to help us survive. Being alive. Being alive. Being
Little Night Music is a 1973 musical with music and lyrics by Stephen Sondheim, inspired by the 1955 Ingmar Bergman film Smiles of a Summer Night. It involves the romantic lives of several couples. Its title is a literal translation in English of the German name for Mozart's Serenade No. 13 for strings in G major, Eine kleine Nachtmusik. This musical also includes the popular song Send in the Clowns.
And the bosoms that droop and go dry. In the meanwhile, there
It's a rip and a bustle and a rustle in the hay, and I'll pitch the quick fantastic with flings and confetti in my petticoats away up high. It's a very short roll from the fling that's for fun to the thigh pressing under the table. It's a very short day till you're stuck with just one, or it has to be done on the sly. In the meanwhile, there are mouths to be kissed before mouths to be fed, and there's many a tryst and there's many a bed. There's a lot I'll have missed, but I'll not have been dead when I die. And a person should celebrate that.
Sweeney Todd, the Demon Barber of Fleet Street, is a 1979 musical with music and lyrics by Stephen Sondheim. It is based on the 1973 play of the same name by Christopher Bond. Sweeney Todd opened on Broadway in 1979 and in the West End in 1980. It won the Tony Award for Best Musical and Olivier Award for Best New Musical. It has since had numerous revivals as well as a film adaptation. Sondheim felt that the addition of music would greatly increase the size of the drama, transforming it into a different theatrical experience, stating later, "What I did to Chris's play is more than enhance it. I had a feeling it would be a new animal. The effect it had at Stratford East in London and the effect it had at the Eurus Theatre in New York are two entirely different effects, even though it's the same play. It was essentially charming over there because they don't take Sweeney Todd seriously. Our production was larger in scope. Hal Prince gave it an epic sense, a sense that this was a man of some size instead of just a nutcase. The music helps give it that dimension."
I was half convinced I'd waken, satisfied enough to dream you. Happily I was mistaken, Joanna. I'll steal you, Joanna.
Marry Me a Little is a 1980 musical with lyrics and music by Stephen Sondheim, conceived by Craig Lucas and Norman Renee. The review sets songs cut from Sondheim's better-known musicals, as well as songs from his then-unproduced musical, Saturday Night, to a dialogue-free plot about the relationship between two lonely New York single people who are in emotional conflict during an evening in their separate one-room apartments. Despite knowing of the other's existence, they never get up the courage to talk to each other, though they imagine what such an encounter might be like.
love me just enough. Cry but not too often. Play but not too rough. Keep a tender distance so we'll both be free. That's the way it ought to be. I'm ready. Marry me a little. Do it with a will. Make a few demands I'm able to fulfill. Want me more than others? Not exclusively. That's the way it ought to be.
Sunday in the Park with George is a 1984 musical with music and lyrics by Stephen Sondheim. It was inspired by the French pointillist painter Georges Seurat's painting A Sunday Afternoon on the Island of La Grande Jatée. The plot revolves around George, a fictionalized version of Seurat, who immerses himself deeply in painting his masterpiece, and his great-grandson, also named George, a conflicted and cynical contemporary artist.
Yes, she looks for me. Good. Let her look for me to tell me why she left me, as I always knew she would. I had thought she understood. They have never understood, and no reason that they should. But if anybody could. Finishing a hat. How you have to finish a hat. How you watch the rest of the world through a window. How you finish the hat. Mapping out a sky. What you feel like planning a sky. What you feel when voices that come through the window go until they distance and die. Until there's nothing but sky. And how you're always turning back too late from the grass or a stick or the dog or the light. How the kind of woman willing to wait's not the kind that you want to find waiting to return you to the night. Dizzy from the height, coming from the hat, studying the hat, entering the world of the hat, reaching through the world of the hat like a window down to this one from that. Studying a face, stepping back to look at a face, leaves a little space away like a window, but to see, it's the only way to see. And when the woman that you wanted goes, you can say to yourself, well, I give what I give. But the woman that won't wait for you knows that however you live, there's a part of you always standing by, mapping out a sky. Finishing a hat. Starting on a hat. Finishing a hat. Look, I made a hat. Well, it never was a hat.
Into the Woods is a 1986 musical with music and lyrics by Stephen Sondheim. The musical intertwines the plots of several Brothers Grimm and Charles Perrault fairy tales, exploring the consequences of the characters' wishes and quests. The main characters are taken from Little Red Riding Hood, Jack and the Beanstalk, Rapunzel, and Cinderella, as well as several others. The musical is tied together by a story involving a childless baker and his wife and their quest to begin a family, their interaction with a witch who has placed a curse on them, and their interaction with other storybook characters during their journey. The musical debuted in San Diego at the Old Globe Theater in 1986 and premiered on Broadway on November 5, 1987, where it won several Tony Awards, including Best Score, Best Book, and Best Actress in a Musical. The musical has since been produced many times and includes a Disney film adaptation that was released in 2014.
Children should listen. What have I been to you? What would you have me be? Handsome like a prince. But I am old, I am ugly, I embarrass you. You are ashamed of me. You are ashamed. You don't understand. Don't you know what's out there in the world? someone has to shield you from the world. Stay with me, princes wait there in the world, it's true. Princes, yes, but wolves and humans too. Stay at home.
To find out more about how NEA grants impact individuals and communities, visit www.arts.gov.